वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम टू माई क्लास. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट लॉन्ग रन मेशर्स ऑफ क्यूइंग सिस्टम. सो दिस इज अंडर मॉडल 2. इट इज अ स्टैटिस्टिकल मॉडल्स इन सिमुलेशन. वॉट इज लॉन्ग रन मेशर्स ऑफ क्यूइंग सिस्टम? लाइक द पीपल हु इज वेटिंग इन अ वेटिंग लाइन और इन अ स्लो लाइन, हाउ मच टाइम दे हैव स्पेंट इन अ सिस्टम एंड एवरेज टाइम स्पेंट इन अ सिस्टम, वी कैन कैलकुलेट इट एज अ लॉन्ग रन मेशर ऑफ अ क्यूइंग सिस्टम. द रिमेनिंग सेशंस विल सी नाउ. So there is a primary long run measures of performance. We can say L is there are so many parameters which they have given for understandable purpose. Like for example, if the average number of customers in a system or average number of customers in a queue, and who the number of customers who is waiting in a waiting line and who is waiting in a system per unit, everything will be given for parameters for easy understandable one. So there is a primary long run measures of performance are L, long run time average number of customers in the system, and LQ, long run time average number of customers in a queue, W, long run time average number spent in system per customer, and WQ, long run average time spent in queue per customer. So next is server utilization. So in previous slides we have discussed server utilization is nothing but either a server is busy or a server is idle. We need to find out. Based on that, we can go for the process. And the thing is, the main thing what we have to understood this calculation and all, how we can simply solve is the inter arrival time of the customer and service time of the customer. So these two things we have to calculate and we can sum up. For example, if the customer is arrival time is 100 and service time is 50, so those two things are 100 plus 50, 150. So for example, if customer is inter arrival time is 200 and if he is services is 100, so 200 plus 100, 300. Okay, so this is a very basic example we can say for calculating the inter arrival time and the service time. And now we will see the server utilization, how it measures. So long run proportion of customers who are delayed longer than T0 time units, and then this is how the measure of interest under the server utilization. Who is going to delay longer than T0 time units and who is turned away because of capacity constraints, and then those who are waiting line more than K0 customers, like so because of no system capacity and there is a stable assumption of the calling infinite calling population. So we have to find out the we can go for measure in the queuing system. And what is the main aim of this section? So the major measures of performance for general GGC NK queuing system, how these measures can be estimated from simulation runs. Normally we know that simulation result or simulation outcome is very difficult to interpret, because in simulation we can't give the clarity of the output or clarity of the result, because everything is in assumptions only. So these kind of things we can estimate it through the estimators. There is two types of estimators. One is sample average and another one is time integrated sample average. So this is the two types of estimators we can go for. And this is the time average number in the system. So how much time the customers waiting in a system, and we can based on the inter arrival time and service time we can sum up. And then there is a discrete point of time, how much arrival time we can takes place. So 0 to 1, there is a discrete point of time. Again, again 0 to 1, there is a particular point of time only the arriving, and then again go back and forth. These are the things which is happening randomly. So this is a random one, and eventually every time a service will be given to the peoples, like because it is a random way. So now consider a queuing system over a period of time. So TI denote the total number during in which a system contain exactly I customer. The time weighted average number in the system is defined by 1 by T summation I equal to 0 to infinity I TI. So this is how we can find out the total time during 0 and T in which a system contain exactly how much customers how much time they have waited and time weighted average number in the system we can find out. So consider the total area under the function is L of t, then the long runtime average number of customers in the system with the probability 1. So this is totally based on the probability density function, and through this we can find out the queuing system, how the total time we can get it for ti by t. And this is a formula for an integral part. L equal to 1 by t, 0 to t is the interval L of t and dt. So this is the average time, average number of customers waiting in a system, customer waiting per unit time. So this is how we can find out time average number in system. We already saw this, the same thing which we have discussed, this one, the same here. So this is time average number in system. So based on the probability we can find out how many what is the average number time where we can calculate. If L of t equal to 0, then we can apply 0, and if L of t greater than or equal to 1, in the sense we can go for 1, 2, 3, etc., etc., and we can go for L of t minus 1. So based on this we can go for probability way. LQ is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like you can give, and based on that we can give the values divided by how much. So we will be getting the number of customers in the system. Average time spent in system per customer. So this is called average system time, 1 by n summation I equal to 1 to n, where W1 and W2 and Wn is the, these are the individual times. These are the individual times that each of the n customers spend in the system during 0 and t. So 0 and t is the interval time. For stable system we can give n implies infinity. So because it's an infinite calling population and we can go for stable systems too. So here if the system under consideration is the queue alone. So like we can go for 1 by n summation wiq implies wq. So n implies infinity is the main thing. Because of a stable system we can calculate the things. So this is the average time spent in a system per customer. This is how we can calculate during the time interval 0, t. So this is per customer, average time spent in system per customer. So the same thing, we are choosing the average queuing time divided by how much. So we'll be getting a time units as per the GG1NK, based on that format notation we can go for it. The same manner will the same sum up, we can get it the time units over here. So thank you.